we have a very close relation between the R&D department and the racing department. We share the long-term development of the bike with the racing people weekly. Without these great racers and the wins, there is not that cool information how to make the winning bike. We can be quite proud of this achievement that we are so close between our stock bikes and the race bikes. I'm totally sure if you give one of these 2022 bikes to Jeffrey Hellings or Tom Vial, they will be on the podium on a GP race.
Of course, when I see the new 2022 models, it feels like even a step closer to the factory bikes. Testing new KTM models has been making me feel unbelievably happy, you know. Now, racing is one thing, but then bringing our feedback and our technology into the standard bike and knowing they use it makes me so happy, because now I could finally ride one of those bikes and I could really witness how great they are.
The base is really good and you feel confident on the bike. And for myself, it's really important to jump on the bike and feel safe.
I'm super surprised about the performance. I personally didn't expect it to be so high. I believe it's only 1 or 2 seconds difference. I wouldn't be saying I would win GPs on that bike, but definitely I could be very competitive, even on a standard bike, yes. I was really surprised about the engine performance on the standard 450 SXF. It has so much torque, you know, it has unbelievable lot of torque, and that's really not far off of my factory engine.
On the bottom of the bike, you feel really, the bike is really response pretty fast. And also on the top, when you really push the bike on the limits, it's also going quite high on the RPM.
The 125 bike is great, and it's a great step between the 85 and the MX2 bike, and I think for 13, 14, 15, 16 year old, it's a great middle step. KTM really got famous about the steel frame. I mean, throughout the years still we find minor changes on the frame and to get better and better.
When the bike is light and easy to turn or to jump, it's really help a lot.
With some minor changes, you know, just some suspension changes, going a little harder, the position of the brake levers, clutch, you know, there's only some small details while I really felt comfortable within a few minutes, you know. It was really easy to set up the bike.
The stock suspension are pretty good. It's a little bit lighter as a fork. And to turn on the tight corner, for me it's an advantage. And also for the braking, you're pretty precise, and this is really important.
The technology of KTM has been high class level, you know, and we've been really been trying as a factory race team to improve on that with the map switch, with the traction control. And it's also on the standard bikes right now. If you could see, like on the brand new 450 SXF, you have the traction control, you have a double map switch. So then as a amateur rider, you can even put it on and you can switch maps very easily with switching one button. So that's a big improvement.
I ride the one gear higher always. The map one is really good for my riding style. I can ride a little bit more smooth.
Second mapping for more power. So as an amateur, you can play a little bit with the power, even if you want more or less. I'm very proud when I see a KTM ride, because I know I've been a very small stone of KTM succession, of not just me, but a lot of factory riders. But I know a little piece of my feedback is in that bike as well.